This is very interesting.
We're naked. We might as well hug here. So.
How weird is this, being out in this place, totally naked?
It's surreal.
Good.
I'm EJ.
I'm Kellie.
Kellie.
Looks
nice like
to
we're
going to
be partners over the next 21 days.
I'm excited.
We got some bags here. Why don't we check and see what we got?
EJ and Kellie are each allowed to bring one essential survival item.
This is the item I chose to bring.
Great.
It's going to help us catch food, build shelters, all kinds of tools. This is a key item for us.
I have a pot. We're going to use it to purify water,
cook food, use as a digging instrument.
With these two things, we're going to be able to do so much.
A small crew will capture the 21-day journey with clear instruction not to intervene unless there is a medical emergency. In addition, EJ and Kellie are given handheld cameras to document their own perspective.
Seems to be working. We've got a microphone.
Awesome.
You ready for the challenge?
Ready to rock it out.
I'm ready to kick
And I have some kind of paper here. Looks like it's a map.
This tree looks like the one we're standing in.
Our survivalists have been given a primitive map of the area. Indicated on it is their extraction point, a small mountain about 5 miles to the west. They'll need to navigate the treacherous terrain and be on top of that mountain 21 days from now, where they'll have to build a signal fire to alert a rescue helicopter. There are small water holes approximately 3 miles to the north. That is the only source of water for hundreds of miles. Humans can only survive without water for 3 days. EJ and Kellie's first priority is to make it there as quickly as possible.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Watch your feet there.
As part of their selection process, EJ and Kellie have undergone rigorous physical and psychological testing. Their survival assessment has been generated using 3 categories: skill, experience, mental. EJ's experience as an Army survival instructor scores him highly, but without his military-issued gear, he may struggle to adapt. Conversely, Kellie has broad experience with primitive survival and plant life, but working as a team could challenge her independent nature. EJ and Kellie are given an overall primitive survival rating. EJ's is set at 7.3, and Kellie's score is a 7.5.
I just saw a fish over there. There you go again.
You see two or one?
I see two.
Awesome. Why don't you try to scare him down to me and I'll come down to the other end.
Fish protein's one of the best sources of protein you can get. And out here, I'm very surprised there's fish in that water pool, but we're gonna get one today.
I think they're over in this hole here.
There
he goes.
Fishy, I'm gonna come get you. I'm gonna catch you with my hands.
So I look behind me, and there's Kellie. She's got her legs all spread out. That is one strange technique.
I never actually caught a fish this way. Just patience. Patience. Woo! Yeah. Fish in the crotch.
Good, 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 good. Nice job, Kellie.
Got him.
Nice.
Kellie?
Yeah.
You're the better fisherman.
Out on Tanzania's savanna, catfish live underground during the dry season in thick, muddy ponds. An internal organ functions as a lung, and they can breathe air. When enough water is present, they emerge out of hibernation.
Good job.
Dinner! Woohoo!
Nice job, Kellie.
Catching fish is a victory. The fact that I caught a fish, it just puts me on more of a level playing field. Maybe now EJ will treat me as an equal, instead of just some woman he's dragging along his excursion.
Awesome, eh?
Nice job. Wait, teach me how to kill a catfish.